Brand new details about that dramatic drive into the ocean caught on tape. A minivan filled with children. Now the startling 911 call and the rescuer seen on tape. All speaking out this morning. ABC's Steve Osunsami is in Daytona this morning with the latest on the mom behind the wheel. Good morning, Steve.
Good morning, Robin. Police are telling us that this mother who was driving into the ocean from the beach directly behind me is pregnant and is undergoing mental evaluations at a local hospital this morning.
This dramatic rescue on the beach, a mother with her three kids inside her minivan driving into the ocean.
Are they saying help?
Her son waving out the window for help. This morning, the two men who tried to convince her to stop tell us she ignored their pleas.
I'll never get the picture out of my head. That little boy had his outstretched arms saying, please help me. Our mom's trying to kill us.
Tim Tessenier from North Carolina was at the beach with his wife, who was recording the video.
When I was speaking to her, her eyes was like,
was wide.
Wide.
Stacy Robinson and his girlfriend were just about to head home when he raced to the minivan, driving into the surf.
By the time I ran over, I get there, I noticed the son was snatching at the wheel, trying to get her to come back towards the shore.
The 6'6" Robinson reached into the passenger side window and never let go, rolling down the windows and unlocking the doors in surf up to his chest. He grabbed two of the children, and the lifeguards came, got the mother out of the car, and rescued a toddler still trapped in a car seat.
The waves were strong, the water was cold. They got in the water, got him out of there quickly. If it had been minutes longer, the outcome probably would have been different.
Now we're learning more about the 32-year-old mother behind the wheel. Ebony Wilkerson drove here from South Carolina.
He's like having psychosis or something.
This is the 911 call from her family to police before the incident, saying she was having, quote, mental issues.
He's talking about Jesus and that there's demons in my house and that I'm trying to control her.
After that call, police say she drove to the beach. This morning, her children are in protective custody.
Police tell us they did reach out to the mother after that call from her relatives, but say that was before the incident here at the beach, so there was nothing they can do. Authorities are telling us they're not sure whether she will be charged with anything or whether they consider this a medical issue. Robin.
All right, Steve, we're going to bring in ABC News Chief Legal Affairs Anchor Dan Abrams to weigh in on all this. And picking up with where Steve just left off about police did talk to the mother prior to, but couldn't do anything.
Right. Under Florida law, there's something called the Baker Act, which allows you to involuntarily confine someone in a mental institution, but only if they have found that there's a substantial likelihood based on recent behavior that the person would be a threat to him or herself or to others. And what the police are saying is, look, we talked to her. She said she was going to a shelter to try to get away from her husband. It all seemed to be legitimate. There was no reason for us to believe that she was going to be a threat to herself or her family. And as a result, we did what we do in almost every case. We let the person go on with his or her life.
And we heard Steve also talking, alluding to the possibility of criminal charges here.
Yeah, look, it's possible. They're going to have to decide whether they believe there was a crime committed, meaning did she have the intent to commit a crime? We always talk about the insanity defense. And if she were tried, no question, that would be the defense in a case like this. But what people forget is sometimes the authorities don't even decide to prosecute. Mm. And they say to themselves, you know what? We don't believe that this person was able to establish the intent to commit a crime. And so that could be what prosecutors decide here and decide, we don't even think there's a crime, right. No need for a trial.
But, you know, the family, they did what they could. I mean, they call in the police,
Everyone in this case did what they should have done. The family, the police went and talked to her.
And those rescuers there on the beach, how quickly they acted.
Unbelievable.
All right, Dan, thank you. Okay.